I know it says you're live now.
Great. Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Paz de Cristo, hermanos. Aquí estamos en nuestro estudio. Gracias a Dios si puedes tener estos estudios todos los semanas. We're just really grateful that we're able to have these studies every week. I appreciate the teachers and just their input and all of that. So praise God. Bienvenidos todos que están entrando. Welcome everyone that's coming on to our study. We've already been talking about the book of James, particularly James chapter 2, and all month long. And so here we're at the end to kind of summarize and just what Brother John has for us. Todo ese mes estamos hablando de Santiago, capítulo 2, y todas las cosas y la manera para servir Dios y que. And so we're just really excited about just the topic. Just in a way of some announcements as we begin, coming up this Saturday, our children's department is having a fall fest, and it's from 11 a.m. to 1, where they just want to get together with the kids and have a little bit of fun, and they have some special things planned. So fall fest, 11 to 1 Saturday at our church. Of course, we're going to follow all the safety regulations as we're supposed to. En este sábado tenemos una actividad por los niños del Departamento de Escuela Dominical. Tienen una actividad este domingo, sábado, sábado. Y a la iglesia comienza a las 11 de la mañana a la 1, so es como 2 horas. Y es solo para tener un cosa positiva por los niños. Hay un predicación, hay juegos y otro cosas por los niños. So, es un buen tiempo por ellos. So it'll be a good time for them. Also, I mean, I know we all, for the most part, all have our smartphones and all of our electronics that set the clock back, but some of you may still have a clock, like a clock radio or something. We're already setting our clocks back this weekend. So we'll be at church a little bit earlier. So just keep that in mind. También este sábado a la noche o a las 2 de la mañana, si cambia nuestros relojes. Oh, I was close. Relojes. Cambia, el tiempo está cambiando. So recuerda esto también. And just keep that in mind. So I think that's pretty much for the announcements. Of course, 10 o'clock on Sundays, we're having our Sunday services in-house. And we're starting to warm up a little bit. You know, it was kind of strange the first week. We had a special service last week. So this week will be a regular service in the church. And so we're, of course, as always, anticipating the move of God. Como siempre, en este domingo a las 10, tenemos nuestro culto que está en casa, ahí en el templo. And so estamos muy contentos que si puede estar adentro. Está calentando los hermanos. Lo primero domingo era un poquito diferente. La semana que pasó era un culto especial, pero ese domingo que viene es todos los servicios son normal, pero es un servicio normal. So pasa, viene a la iglesia. Si no, está bien. A mí tenemos todos, como siempre, las reglas y todo está bien, todo está seguros. Pero si no, ahí estamos, Facebook, como siempre. So like always, we're on Facebook, but we're inviting you out to our Sunday service. But of course, we understand if you'd rather just stay home, and we'll be there. We'll be live on Facebook. Okay, why don't I have the brothers just kind of greet, why don't you greet everyone as they're joining, and then we'll get into hear what the Lord has put on Brother John's heart for us tonight.
Praise the Lord, everyone. I'm happy to be here with you all. It has been a great, wonderful day just being alive and blessing with whatever God had decided to throw my way today, and hopefully it's been the same for you. We have positives, we have negatives, but the thing is, God is consistent, and it's all just building to blessings on blessings. I believe that. I claim that. And yeah, I'm just looking forward to the word tonight as well. So whatever our questions are, whatever our comments are, please, please, please share them with us. We want to grow in the word together. We want to be iron sharpening iron. And yeah, looking forward to the lesson.
Amen. Amen.
Paz de Cristo, hermanos, una vez más me da gusto estar con ustedes. Y es cierto lo que dice nuestro hermano Daniel. Nos levantamos ya sea con problemas o nos levantamos con cosas buenas. Lo interesante, lo importante es qué es lo que hacemos nosotros para comenzar. Okay, we can get up in a bad mood or we can get up in a good mood. But the important thing is, what do we do with it? How do we start doing? Are we going to keep a positive attitude? And that's a really good thing. So estoy contento de estar una vez más aquí con ustedes, con mis hermanos. El pastor está de regreso y nos da gusto de que esté con nosotros. Gracias a los que estuvieron orando por ellos y les agradecemos a todos los que nos acompañan en esta noche. Y sí, muy importante, como lo decimos una y otra vez, por favor comparta, póngale like, póngale share a estos mensajes para que llegue y alcance a más hermanos. Oh, we want to reach out into as many people as we can. It's nothing about, and all of my brothers know, it's nothing about being popular. God knows, it's about sharing the word, because I believe we're living in the last days, and it is a great important thing to share. Compartan, porque estamos, yo sé que mis hermanos están de acuerdo conmigo, estamos viendo los últimos días y es importante compartir, hermanos. Hay que compartir, que el mundo sepa que esta es la respuesta y la salida a un mundo en medio de mucha dificultad. Y gracias por acompañarnos, hermanos. Los amamos en el Señor. Compártalo, por favor, que alguien más reciba.
Amen. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. It's good to be here with you again tonight. Just pray for me. I have huge butterflies in my stomach. I was going to say get a paper and pencil because there's a few verses, but I forget technology. You can just play it over. But anyway, good to be here. Pray for us, pray for each other, pray for all those that are sick, those that are being told that they're sick, those that are being told that their rent is past due, just whatever. But God is good. God has us in his hand, and nothing can take us out. Paz de Cristo, hermanos. Es un placer estar con ustedes en esta noche. Me he dicho en inglés que a lo mejor necesitan un lápiz y papel porque va a haber varias escrituras, pero también dije que yo no sé de esta tecnología que pueden nomás tocarlo otra vez. So, como lo hagan, que ustedes oigan lo que Dios tenga para ustedes en esta noche. That you hear what God wants you to hear. Let's pray for each other. Let's pray for all the church and the whole world, the whole nation. Everybody, in the name of Jesus, God bless you.
Amen. Why don't we just go ahead and open with a word of prayer, and we'll take Brother John's suggestion and just pray for our church, our community, and just those that that are struggling in whatever way. And so quiero comenzar con una oración. Después orar por todo la iglesia, nuestras comunidades, nuestras familias. Hay muchos que están sufriendo sin Dios. Y también hay muchos hermanos que tienen Dios y están sufriendo, pero ellos tienen esperanza en Él. También oramos por el presidente de los varones de nuestro distrito, Ken Bazan. Está muy enfermo y oramos por él, está en el hospital. So let's keep him in prayer. Ken Basson, the District Verona's president, in Jesus' name. So I'm going to ask Brother Vargas. Brother Vargas, why don't you go ahead and pray, brother, for the lesson, and just that the Lord speaks and speaks to the hearts that are listening. You're muted, my brother.
Amén, hermanos. Oímos a nuestro hermano Lage mencionando sobre los que están también pasando por necesidades y para pagar su renta, para el pago de la casa o la comida. Vamos a hacer una oración especial también por ellos. Como dijo nuestro pastor, nuestro hermano Bazán, y todos los que en este momento están acompañándonos, que Dios abra entendimiento y así de la misma manera Dios unja los labios de nuestro hermano. En nombre de Jesús, Padre eterno, estamos delante de tu presencia. Gracias porque nos das esta oportunidad. En este momento muchas personas quisieran tener este privilegio, Padre, pero tú no lo has dado a nosotros, de poder allegarnos a ti, de poder buscar tu presencia, Señor. Y te invitamos a que tomes parte, Señor. No parte, que tomes control, Señor, de esta noche, de esta enseñanza y a la vez de nuestras vidas. Te rogamos en nombre de Jesús, nuestro hermano Bazán, que tú lo toques en este momento, el presidente, los varones. Sabemos que Él está en tus manos, pero tú eres Dios soberano y sobre todo, y tú tienes el poder para obrar, para sanar, para tocar las vidas, los corazones. Bendice a cada uno de mis hermanos, a los que nos acompañan en este momento también, Señor, porque todos tienen necesidades. All of our brothers and sisters that are joining at this time, Lord, they also have a need, and they have a special need, something that they can probably mention, but you know, God, and we place it in your hands for you to move in a mighty way as you always do. For you know that you do what you do, and when you do a miracle, God, we all receive a benefit from it, because we know that you are glorified every time we hear that you move in a mighty way. Bless my brother John. Lord, anoint the lips of clay and speak to all of us, God, so that we might receive from you. And somebody that might be watching at this moment might get a word of wisdom. Alguien que esté mirando en este momento reciba palabra de sabiduría, Señor, y una respuesta tal vez para la situación en la cual se encuentra en este momento. Te rogamos en el nombre de Jesús. Amén y amén.
Amen. Thank you, brother. At this time, I'm going to turn this place over to Brother John and, all you, my brother.
Again, praise the Lord. Otra vez, paz de Cristo. Espero que Dios arregle mis palabras, que no sean mías, que ustedes oigan lo que Dios les quiere decir en esta noche. That not my words, but what God wants you to hear is what you will hear tonight. God's word is good and alive, and it's good in all season. La palabra de Dios es viva y eficaz y buena para todo tiempo. Last month we touched on Philippians 2:5, which says, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus." I think it ties in with today's lesson as well. We need to love God. We need to love our neighbors. We need to have self-control, and we need to serve others. That's why in 1 Peter 1:13 it says, "So prepare your minds for service with complete self-control. Put all your hope in the grace that will be yours when Jesus Christ comes." El mes pasado hablamos sobre Filipenses 2:5, que dice así, "Haya pues en vosotros este sentir que hubo también en Cristo Jesús." Y yo creo que estas palabras se unen también para la lección en esta noche. Necesitamos amar a Dios primeramente y también a nuestro prójimo. Necesitamos tener dominio propio y necesitamos servir a la comunidad. En Primera de Pedro 1:13 dice, "Por eso, preparen su mente para servir con pleno dominio propio. Pongan toda su esperanza en el glorioso amor que será de ustedes cuando Cristo Jesús venga." Amen. And today it's true religion. Y hoy, este mes, es religión pura. que se encuentra en Santiago 1, 13 al 27, which is found in James 1, 13 through 27. So let us look at how we can reach pure religion. We need to prepare your mind for service in God's kingdom. We need to have the true response to God's word, which involves both outward activity and inward control. We minister to the needs, that's outer activity. Our separation from the worldly desires, that's the evidence of the inner control. We need to be aware and prepared. We need to keep our focus on God. Vamos a ver, estudiar poquito, a ver cómo vamos a poder alcanzar esta religión pura. Tenemos que preparar nuestra mente para servir en el reino de Dios. Tenemos que tener la respuesta verdadera a la palabra de Dios que envuelve dos cosas, la actividad exterior y el control interior. Al ministrar a las necesidades es la actividad de afuera, exterior. La separación de los deseos del mundo es la evidencia del control del interior. Necesitamos estar conscientes, preparados para poder mantener nuestro enfoque en Dios. James 1, 13 through 15. Let no one say when he is tempted, I am tempted by God, for God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he himself tempt anyone. But each one is tempted when he is drawn away by his own desires and enticed. Then, when desire has conceived, it gives birth to sin, and sin, when it is full grown, brings forth death. Santiago 1, 13 al 15. Cuando alguno es tentado, no diga que es tentado de parte de Dios, porque Dios no puede ser tentado por el mal, ni él tienta a nadie, sino que cada uno es tentado cuando de su propia pasión es atraído y seducido. Entonces la pasión, después que ha concebido, da luz al pecado, y el pecado, siendo consumador, da luz a la muerte. Verse 14, just a couple of things. Sin has power over the believer only when it is encouraged by the believer. Proverbs 19:3, the foolishness of a man twists his way, and his heart frets against the Lord. Dos cosas o una del verso 14. El pecado tiene poder sobre el creyente, pero solamente cuando es estimulado por el creyente. Proverbios 19:3 nos dice, la insensatez del hombre tuerce su camino y luego se irrita en su corazón contra Jehová. So that's something. We get our way twisted and then we kind of want to blame it on God, that he let it happen, that he tempted us, and it's not God, it's us. Es poco extraño que hacemos lo que hacemos y luego nos enojamos con Dios. Dios permitió esto. Dios, dejó que esto pasara y lo culpamos a él cuando Dios no tuvo nada que ver con eso. Eso todo fue de parte de nosotros. Verse 15. Let's go to the beginning. In Genesis 3:6. So when the woman saw that the tree was good, okay, so when the woman saw, and I'm not emphasizing on woman, but saw that the tree was good for food, okay, what's wrong with that? That it was pleasant to the eyes, wow, okay, and a tree desirable to make one wise. She took of its fruit and ate. She also gave it to her husband with her, and he ate. Let's note here, temptation gets our attention. We feed the thought We imagine how tasty it's going to be. And then we desire it. And we convince ourselves that it will be worth it. Génesis, vamos hasta el principio. En Génesis 3, 6, dice, al ver la mujer que el árbol era bueno para comer, nada malo ahí, agradable a los ojos, okay, y deseable para alcanzar la sabiduría. Tomó de su fruto y comió y dio también a su esposo, a su marido, el cual comió la igual que ella. La tentación agarra nuestra atención y alimentamos esos pensamientos. Alimentamos esa tentación y luego nos imaginamos qué sabroso va a ser, qué bueno va a ser. Y luego lo deseamos y nos hacemos creer que vale la pena. To live in the presence of God consistently, we must expose and expel our rebellion. When we are tempted or we get angry, we need to call on God in that moment. Cry out to God and the evil will flee. Cry out, as it says in Psalm 139, verses 23 and 24. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my anxieties. And see if there is any wicked way in me. And help me in the way everlasting. Para vivir en la presencia del Señor de Dios constantemente, tenemos que exponer y expulsar nuestra rebelión. Cuando somos tentados o nos enojamos, tenemos que pedirle a Dios en ese momento. Tenemos que clamar a Dios y el mal va a huir. Tenemos que clamar, como nos dice en Salmo 139, versos 23 y 24. Oh Dios, examíname. Reconoce mi corazón. Ponme a prueba. Reconoce mis pensamientos. Mira si voy por el camino mal y guíame por el camino eterno. I just want to throw in, you all know that I'm not perfect. And I kind of went across this and I learned it and I memorized it and I've tried it. When something wants to frazzle you and somebody asks you for something, or when whatever, you want to get upset, you want to rebel, say these two verses. And it just goes away. Quiero decir, estaba diciendo, ustedes saben bien que yo no soy perfecto y he aprendido esto y lo he calado, lo he probado. Cuando algo me quiere frustrar o hacer enojar o algo, lo he usado y libre soy, gracias a Dios. Poco a poco nos va cambiando. Little by little, he'll be changing us. So on this thing of giving up and all that, Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of soup. This story is found in Genesis 25, verses 29 through 34, but there also is, it's mentioned in Hebrews 12, 16 and 17. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person like Esau, who for one morsel of food sold his birthright. For you know that afterward, when he wanted to inherit the blessing, he was rejected, for he found no place for repentance, though he sought it diligently with tears. A plate of food, satisfaction for a moment. Esau didn't value his inheritance, his future, his place of honor, after he was sorry for his lack of judgment, but the harm was already done, gone, final. The good thing for us now is that if we repent and come back to God, he will forgive us. But we risk. Don't try it, because we risk the danger of not finding our way back to God. También voy a mencionar a Esaú. Esaú vendió su primogenitura por un plato de comida. La historia está en Génesis 25:29-34, pero también lo menciona en Hebreos 12:16-17. No sea que haya algún fornicario o profano como Esaú, que por una sola comida vendió su primogenitura. Porque ya sabes que aún después, deseando haber heredado la bendición, fue desechado, pues no halló oportunidad para el arrepentimiento, aunque la procuró con lágrimas. Un plato de comida. Se suena ridículo, pero ¿por qué en veces le decimos a Dios ahorita no? Por un momento de satisfacción. Él por un plato de comida, satisfacción por un momento. Y Saúl no le dio el valor a su herencia, a su futuro, a su lugar de honor. Y nosotros todos lo tenemos, una herencia, tenemos futuro, tenemos un lugar de honor con nuestro Padre. Sí, se puso triste después por su falta de pensar, pero ya el daño ya fue hecho, ya se le fue quitado, ya era final. Gracias a Dios que en estos días tenemos la oportunidad, si nos arrepentimos, a volver para atrás a Dios y Él nos va a perdonar. Pero tengan cuidado porque tomamos el riesgo y el peligro de no poder hallar el camino para atrás a Dios.
You know, Brother John, I mean, I appreciate what you're saying and what you're teaching, and even the examples that you're giving. And, you know, I think that's the trickiness about temptation, because I know I was taught for the longest time that to be tempted is to be sinning. But we know that that's the one of the ways of the enemy, but maybe even just our own human nature, where temptation is not sin. Temptation is trying to lure us into giving into a sinful act or sinfulness or something that's just, you know, not beneficial. And it's true, like Esau, like you're saying, I mean, us, we're like, how ridiculous is that? Like, he's hungry. But isn't that the thing about temptation, where it glorifies this forbidden thing? Like even with Adam and Eve, where this fruit is to be not touched, and it's then just, you know, like glorified in a sense that, hey, everything's going to change. Life's going to be so much better, you know, and then we regret it. I mean, we've all done it, and even in the most simplest things, you know, eating, you know, a second slice of cake or something, you know, like we're just like, oh no, why did I do that? Why did I eat so much? Why, you know, and I think that's the whole, you know, luring us in. I was just talking to someone, if it wasn't this week, it was last week, where they thought some very human feelings were like these temptations and felt very guilty. And I was telling them that, no, your feelings are normal. Now, what you do with the feelings, if it leads you to do something that might be sinful, but then that's the sin, you know? And I don't know about all of you, you could probably chime in, even Brother John, but I'm just saying that You know, sometimes people say, well, I'm giving, okay, forget it. I've given in, I'm going in. If I'm going, I'm going big, right? And just kind of throw everything away. And then you're right to navigate back. Not that God doesn't forgive. He'll forgive in a spot. He's waiting. Come back. But it's us to navigate back. How could I? The guilt. Oh, I just might as well have another drink. I might as well, whatever it is. So, yeah, I think that's part of what Paul says in Ephesians 6, you know, that to understand the wiles of the devil, right? To understand the ways. And the ways is, one of the ways is temptation. Because, you know, I'm going to do it. I'm going to be happier. But we know it's not true. But yeah, but great thought thus far.
Anybody else?
Amén, hermano. Yo nomás quiero también comentar un poquito en lo que usted dijo, porque lo que estoy mirando, ¿verdad? Lo que está poniendo nuestro hermano John nos está enseñando un ejemplo de cómo la tentación está en sí, está al frente de nosotros. Okay, temptation is right in front of us, pretty much all the time. Está enfrente de nosotros y los ejemplos que nuestro hermano nos dio de Esaú y de Génesis, de cómo la mujer fue tentada, de cómo este muchacho también cambió su primogenitura por un plato de lentejas, básicamente. Entonces, la tentación está ahí, pero lo que me gusta de todo esto es que tenemos esa oportunidad, como dice nuestro hermano, regresar a la respuesta. We can go back once again to the answer. The answer is in Christ, because we understand this and just basically leaning a little bit on the topic, true religion. A lot of people believe that through rituals is easier to reconcile with God, when in reality we understand that it's actually through His Word. Lo que me refiero es que muchas personas piensan que por medio de rituales es una manera más fácil de reconciliarse con Dios, hermano John. Y en realidad la palabra nos enseña que por medio de Cristo encontramos una vez más el camino a la reconciliación. Entonces, ningún ritual que esté fuera de la palabra de Dios, yo pienso que nos puede ayudar a reconciliarnos con Él. Porque miramos que la causa de la caída de estas personas que cayeron en tentación fue la desobediencia. You know, these people fall into temptation because of disobedience. So, the answer is in Christ. So, no ritual, ningún ritual, ningún otro medio nos va a poder dar la tranquilidad que nosotros necesitamos. Y es cierto, muchos desesperadamente o se desesperan porque piensan que no hay un medio para regresar. Many, many are desperate because they believe that there's not a way to turn back from making a mistake. And we know it right now. There's a great percentage of a man and woman committing suicide because of the same reasons. Hay muchas, un gran porcentaje de hombres y mujeres que están acudiendo al suicidio a causa de esto, porque piensan que no existe una salida. Pero en Cristo nosotros encontramos el camino perfecto una vez más hacia la reconciliación. Ah, nomás quería añadir a eso, hermano John, a lo que usted está mencionando.
Very good. Gracias, hermanos.
Real quick, what I'm really enjoying about the emphasis so far has been, it truly is all on us and our mindset. Because right now what I'm doing as well, for those that are wondering why I'm constantly looking down, is I'm writing down all the verses Brother Olaga is giving so I can post them at the end of the lesson, so they're all in one comment for everybody. And just reading through like the subheadings I'm putting on them to know what they are. Just again, the focus that it's all on, not necessarily just our mindset, but just where our focus is at. Because, you know, the things that come to tempt us are things that, as we know, are desirable to us, or they're going to just captivate us. And in a sense, we're left mystified, like as in perplexed, as how this thing is so great and all that. And we don't realize what's going on. Like the story of Esau right there, you know, I was reading Real quick, just again, he wasn't one that was really concerned for spiritual blessings or just really focused on things like that. So that's why giving his birthright over the plate was no big deal to him. He's like, dude, whatever, I'm hungry, I need food, just take this thing, I don't care. And it's just, again, that mindset of just, for lack of better phrasing, the mindset of not really having the reverence for the things God has blessed us with, or just the awareness of the things God bestows upon us and again blesses us with. And that's what I really enjoy, that it's a very sobering point that you're making right now, that it is very mentally focused, in the sense where yes, God is present and fights the battles for us, but we need to be present within our battles as well, because we're the vessel that's being attacked. So we need to make sure our focus is always on God, so when the attack comes, it's deferred to him rather than us being overwhelmed by it without realizing we're being overwhelmed by it.
Amen. So not changing gears or anything, but now James 1:17, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning. The Bible declares that God is faithful. Numbers 23:19 says, God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should repent. He, has he said, and will he not do? Or has he spoken, and will he not make it good? Ahora vamos a Santiago capítulo 1, al verso 17, donde dice, toda buena dádiva y todo don perfecto desciende de lo alto, del Padre de las luces, en el cual no hay mudanza ni sombra de variación. Y en Números 23, 19 nos dice, Dios no es hombre para que mienta, ni hijo de hombre para que se arrepienta. ¿A causa dice y no hace? ¿A causa promete y no lo cumple? No, Dios es fiel. God is faithful. And in John also says, in Primera de Juan, también nos habla. 1 John chapter 1, verses 5 through 7. This is the message which we have heard from him and declare to you, that God is light and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another and with the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, that cleanses us from all sin. En Primera de Juan, capítulo 1, versos 5 al 7, dice, este es el mensaje que hemos oído de él y os anunciamos. Dios es luz y no hay ningunas tinieblas en él. Si decimos que tenemos comunión con él y andamos en tinieblas, mentimos y no practicamos la verdad. Pero si andamos en luz, como él está en luz, tenemos comunión unos con otros, y la sangre de Jesucristo, su Hijo, nos limpia de todo pecado. That's pretty clear. So I'm going to move on to James 1:22. Eso es claro. No voy a añadir más. So ahora vamos a Santiago 1:22. But be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. Santiago 1:22. Ser hacedores de la palabra y no tan solamente oidores, engañándonos a vosotros mismos. In James chapter 2, verses 14 and 17, en el mismo libro de Santiago, pero capítulo 2, 14 a 17, dice, it says in English, what does it profit a brethren if someone says he has faith but does not have works? Can faith save him? If a brother or sister is naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you says to him, depart in peace, be warmed and filled. But you do not give him the things which are needed for the body. What does it profit? Thus also faith by itself does not have works is dead. Santiago, el mismo libro, capítulo 2, versos 14 al 17, nos dice, hermanos míos, ¿de qué aprovecha si alguno dice que tiene fe y no tiene obras? ¿Podrá la fe salvarlo? Y si un hermano o una hermana están desnudos y tienen necesidad de mantenimiento de cada día, y alguno de vosotros le dice, id en paz, calentaos y saciaos, pero no les das las cosas que son necesarias para el cuerpo, ¿de qué provecha? Así también la fe, si no tiene obras, está completamente muerta. So faith and works, I had to include this in Hebrews 11:17. Cuando habla de fe y obras, tuve que incluir esto. Hebrews 11:17, by faith, Abraham, when he was tested, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises offered up his only begotten son. There's a lot of things Abraham did. I just have two or three. Abraham left his home, not knowing where God was going to lead him or take him. Abraham and Sarah, they believed God that they would have a son in their old age. Sarah was in her 90s and Abraham was 100. And then Abraham had faith and he believed, even when he was asked to offer his only promised son that he had waited so long for. This shows us that Abraham had a lot of faith, lots of faith. But would we have this great example if his faith wasn't followed by his obedient actions? En Hebreos 11:17 nos dice, habla de Abraham, por la fe Abraham, cuando fue probado, ofreció a Isaac, el que había recibido las promesas, ofrecía su unigénito. Abraham dejó su casa y no sabía dónde Dios lo iba a llevar. Y Sara y Abraham creyeron y tuvieron fe cuando se les fue dicho que iban a tener un hijo. Y eso que Sara estaba en los 90s y Abraham ya tenía 100 años. Y él estaba dispuesto, creía, tenía fe que Dios iba a hacer algo y estaba dispuesto a ofrecer, sacrificar a su único hijo que fue prometido. Esto nos enseña claramente que Abraham tenía fe, mucha fe. Es el padre de la fe. Yo creo nadie más tuvo tanta fe como él. Pero, ¿qué de este ejemplo tan grande? Si él no hubiera de haber obedecido con acciones de obedecimiento. Si nomás creía, pero no hacía nada. Él no nomás creía, él tenía sus acciones. So, él tenía la fe y tenía las obras y en todo y por todo y en todo era bendecido. So, he had the faith. He had the works to back it up. So, he was greatly blessed.
Yeah, Brother John, I like the point that you're making there in James 1, 17, where you had read it, where it's saying, you know, every good gift comes from, you know, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights. But I like what James says there, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning, which literally he's encouraging the reader, saying, look at, this isn't just a statement that I'm making about these good gifts or how good God is. there's no variation, or it's not like a shadow, right? Because sometimes there's a shadow, sometimes there's not a shadow. Shadows come and go. That's really what he's referring to. And he's really, you know, you're talking about faith. He's really saying, look, we can have faith in God, or we can have faith in this idea that he's a good father and he gives good things, even though sometimes we may not think they're good, but that's something else. But here he's saying we have the confidence because it's not like a shadow, you know, it's consistent. He's constant and consistent and is going to do what he's going to say. And I think that you bringing up Abraham is really, you know, just a good example, because we know, or at least we us four here know, and probably a lot that are watching know, that, you know, when he was promised a child, it was a one dime thing. You know, he just, and then 25 years later, he had the child. That's why he's known as the father of faith. He believed it, a one time prophecy kind of thing for the most part. You know, where here God, I don't know about y'all can speak for yourselves. I know God's always talking, encouraging me, like, you know, like this is going to happen or that's going to, you know. I think it's just a good point, an encouraging point. You know, it's very encouraging.
Si me permite brincar ahí, hermano, I just want to jump in really quick. Tocó otro punto también bien importante de cómo ayudar al necesitado, you know, to help the needy, to do the work. Hay quienes piensan que este es uno de los rituales, pero no tiene que ver nada con ningún ritual. You know, many will believe that they have to do a ritual in order for them to feel closer to God, but really, what we really need to do is what Brother John was saying, to help the needy, to go visit the widow, ayudar al necesitado, ayudar a la viuda, porque si yo con simplemente ser bueno, si, if I'm only a good person, and I believe that that's good enough, I'm a good person, I read the Bible, and I believe in God, and that's good enough, we're learning that we have to do this work of faith. Of faith is a work of faith. Sabemos que si creemos en el Señor, ¿verdad? Y conocemos la Biblia y creemos mucho en Él, pero si simplemente no hacemos ninguna obra, en realidad lo que nosotros tenemos que hacer la obra, porque la obra es la manifestación de la fe. Cuando uno va y ayuda a alguien, cuando uno da un paso a extremo, tal vez para ayudar a una persona que se encuentra necesitada. You know, when somebody goes over the street sometimes to help somebody else, viene siendo una bendición para la persona aún desconocida. Yo recuerdo cuando los hermanos al principio, cuando yo recién me casé, los hermanos, a veces que yo no tenía, ellos venían y traían bolsas de comida a mi casa. You know, I remember the brothers when I first got married, we didn't have enough food in our house. And there was times when all of a sudden they just came in, and that really showed me their faith, because I was just thinking, I know they're also needy, and they're bringing me some. Yo sé que ellos también están necesitados y también me están trayendo algo. Entonces, esa es la obra de fe. Esa es la verdad. Esa es la verdadera religión. That is the true religion. Cuando uno por fe, a veces que aunque uno no tiene, uno por fe hace por ayudar a alguien más. When someone, even out of faith, even though you might don't have what they need, but you, out of faith, you try to make an effort to help someone. That is the true religion. That's la verdadera fe. Thank you, Brother John. That is a good point too.
Very good. Thank you. And then something you said is faith. Faith also is that when God asks you to do something for somebody, that you're not, I don't know where that came from, or he probably doesn't really need it, or whatever. Faith is that God is trying to send you, and by faith, you should obey and go take him a gallon of milk. Estoy diciendo que cuando el hermano estaba hablando, que también la fe puede ser algo simple con que Dios te pone en el corazón que tu hermano necesita un galón de leche, pero tú vas a pensar, no creo, no sé de dónde vino ese pensamiento. Yo creo que no, él no, ni le gusta la leche, you know, whatever, but la fe es que creer que Dios te ha hablado, y la obra es que vas a obedecer y vas a llevarle el galón de leche. Y los dos ser bendecidos. And both of them.
Hermano Johnny, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but a sentence just came to my mind that now that you're saying those words, I don't know if Brother Bruno remembers. This was years ago, Brother Bruno, maybe around 10 years back or so. Esto pasó, no sé si el hermano Bruno recuerda, hace como unos 10 años atrás o más. Pero un día el hermano Bruno vino y me dijo, hermano Vargas, aquí están $50. Yo no sé por qué Dios me puso en mi corazón dártelos a ti. No sé por qué. Y no, la mera verdad, no me interesa saber. Nomás Dios me puso dártelos en el corazón a ti. You know, I'm saying, Brother Bruno one time came to me and he says, Brother Vargas, here's $50. I don't know and I don't care, but God put it in my heart to give him to you. And I'm all like, but brother, I don't need it. I'm good right now. I have money. I don't know. You do with them, whatever it is that you got to do. God put it on my heart to give him to you. And that's what I'm doing. Yo le dije, hermano, pero yo estoy bien. No me hace falta dinero. Dice, no. Dios me puso en mi corazón dártelos a ti y tú haz con ellos lo que tengas que hacer. Entonces yo recuerdo que fue a mi casa y yo iba rascándome la cabeza y I was scratching my head as I was on my way home. Y le dije a mi esposa, el hermano me dio $50 y no sé ni para qué, ¿verdad? You know, they gave me $50 and I don't even know for what. Y llegamos a la casa y vino una pareja de hermanos a visitarnos. These brothers came to visit us. They just came to the house. Y just by talking to them, we offered them to eat. Al hablar con ellos, les ofrecimos cenar con nosotros. Y una historia corta, pues, a long story short, es that el hermano dijo, pues salimos porque teníamos hambre y pues no tenemos dinero. Y dijimos, pues vamos al menos a caminar. You know, they were saying, we went out because we are hungry. We don't really have money to buy food. And we just decided to go out for a walk. And then I said to myself, oh, so I'm the messenger. Yo me dije a mí mismo, entonces yo soy el mensajero. Entonces yo tuve que sacar, dije, voy a honrar lo que hizo el hermano Bruno. Y yo voy a poner otro 50 en... You know, I put another 50 in there and gave them to the brothers. And I realized that I couldn't have cut the blessing that God was sending to somebody else. Yo no pude cortar la bendición que Dios le estaba enviando a alguien más. Pero I don't know if you remember that, Brother Bruno. That was about 10 or so years back.
Nice.
Okay, so jump in anytime. We're almost done. The last verse in Chapter 1 of James, pure and undefiled religion before God and the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their trouble and to keep oneself unspotted from the world. El último versículo en el capítulo 1 de Santiago nos dice la religión pura y sin mancha delante de Dios es el Padre es esta. Visitar a los huérfanos y a las viudas en sus tribulaciones y guárdense sin mancha del mundo. When we serve in the kingdom of God, helping the needy, and it's in the church and out in the world, we need to have the love of God guide us. If we run into trouble or rejection, we need to call on God to take away that anxiety. If we're doing the will of God, then he's going to be with us. But things come up and we easily get distracted. But we need his love to guide us. We do this because of love, because this is what we're supposed to do. Not out of obligation, but out of faith and love. Cuando vamos a servir en el reino de Dios, ayudando a los necesitados, si es en la iglesia o afuera de la iglesia, tenemos que tener el amor de Dios que nos guíe. Y si nos encontramos con problemas o rechazo, necesitamos clamar a Dios para que Él pueda quitar toda iniquidad. Y hacer eso, estamos siendo obedientes, lo tenemos que hacer porque tenemos el amor de Dios, porque tenemos amor a la gente, no de obligación, no para que nos den la estrellita de oro junto a nuestro nombre, es porque eso es la cosa, eso es el amor. Pero tenemos que tener cuidado también. Tengo los últimos versículos. So we have to do this not to gain or earn our little gold star, but because of love. The love that God is love, and the love that we have in us, which is God, to help and be there for other people. But we also have to watch out for this. My last verses are found in 1 John chapter 2, verses 15 and 7 through 17. Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world is passing away, and the lust of it. But he who does the will of God abides forever. I just want to point something out here. What happened in those examples that I gave of the ones that didn't resist the temptation in the garden and Esau? It was the lust of the flesh, and which is everything carnal. The lust of the eyes is what we see and what we want. And the pride of life is we want to make sure that we're recognized as somebody. And those are the dangers of when we go out into the world. That's when it says that that we not be stained by the world. We need to resist all of those things, and yet at the same time do good unto others. En Primera de Juan 2, 15 al 17, nos dice, no améis al mundo ni las cosas que están en el mundo. Si alguno ama al mundo, el amor del Padre no está en él. Porque nada de lo que hay en el mundo, los deseos de la carne, los deseos de los ojos y la vanagloria de la vida proveen del Padre, sino del mundo. Y el mundo pasa y sus deseos, pero el que hace la voluntad de Dios permanece para siempre. So nomás para ya acabar, quiero que se fijen. Eso es lo que le pasó en el jardín y Esaú, que los deseos de la carne le pusieron atención, le dieron alimento a eso. Los deseos de los ojos, se miró bien, se miró sabroso, y le pusieron atención a eso, y la vanagloria de la vida, que querían la sabiduría, que querían tener lo que querían a ese momento. Eso es lo que tenemos que cuidar, de no ser manchados del mundo, porque esas cosas son del mundo. Este es mi hablar. Muchas gracias por su atención. Espero que Dios los bendiga, que hay algo que puedan llevarse con ustedes. This is my talk for tonight. That God bless you. I pray that there was something that you can take with you, and that God has spoken, and he can fill any need. He can touch, he can heal, I told you kind of like the secret to resist temptation is, Lord, search me. Search me. If you find something wrong, make it right. Help me. He'll be there. Como mencioné, que Dios les dé la respuesta a su necesidad, si es sanidad o ayuda de otra manera, o también de resistir la tentación. Como les dije, que yo lo he probado y sí trabaja. Cuando viene y te quiere pegar, te quiere tentar, clama, Dios mío, mírame, mira mi corazón, pruébame, ponme en prueba, ayúdame. Si estoy en camino mal, enderece mis caminos. Y Él te va a sacar de lo que sea. es todopoderoso. He'll rescue you from anything and everything because he is all powerful. God bless you. Dios les bendiga.
Yeah, amen. I mean, esto es verdad. Dios es grande, nada es imposible por él. En claro, nosotros somos humanos y aquí estamos en este mundo y buscando y viviendo y batallando con todas las cosas que están aquí. Pero you know, Dios está con nosotros y habla y mueve, quiere mover en nuestra vida, quiere hablar, quiere ayudar, pero es siempre... Nosotros necesitamos buscarlo. Y él, en muchas maneras, se ha hablado en esos estudios que él no está esperando que nosotros estamos perfectos. Él sabe que nosotros, la Biblia dice, nosotros somos tierra. No me gusta esto, pero la Biblia dice que nosotros somos tierra. Él sabe que si tiene en nuestros corazones. Pero no es importante él, es claro, es importante, pero él sabe cómo nosotros somos, and él quiere ayudar. Y, you know, God is good and God is great, and we know that. And, you know, he knows what we're made of. And, you know, he's not seeking us to be perfect because he knows who we are. And we're here in this world, we live in this world, we're surrounded by things, we deal with things, we have to live with things. That's just how it is. But in that, God wants to move and speak and touch our hearts. He knows that we're just made of dirt. That's what the psalmist says. That's not very flattering. It doesn't make me feel good. But the point is he knows our makeup. And so, you know, that's why he's with us and wants to work with us and have us grow. So, but I appreciate the lesson and the nuggets that you dug out for us, brother. Thank you so much. I don't know if the other brothers have some comments that they'd like to make as we're wrapping this up.
No más rápidamente, si algo podemos aprender es que Dios nos ha dado libertad a toda su creación. God has granted liberty to his whole creation, a toda su creación. Por eso miramos que hay unos ángeles que decidieron ellos decidieron desobedecer a Dios, por eso fueron echados. I mean, we learned that there's some angels that they were disobedient to God, and that's the reason why they were cast out. I mean, they rebelled against God. Mm-hmm. So that means that they were free to make their decisions. Ellos eran libres de hacer sus decisiones, así como nosotros somos libres de hacer nuestras decisiones. Dios nos ha dado libertad a todos nosotros. ¿Cómo la usamos? Depende de nosotros. Si lo usamos queriendo nosotros justificarnos con la ley vino a castigar al desobediente, vino con amenazas de muerte para castigar al desobediente. You know, if we want to abide to the law and be justified by the law was placed with a punishment of death to the disobedience. Pero si nos agarramos de la ley de Jesús, la ley de Jesús vino para salvar nuestros pecados, así dándonos vida. You know, the law of Jesus came to give us life and to forgive us our sins. So that's our resource. Esa es nuestra oportunidad. Ese es nuestro medio para regresar y agarrarnos del Señor. Entonces, recuerden, Dios nos hizo libres a todos. Y en esa libertad es para que nosotros decidamos si vamos a acercarnos a Dios o si vamos a decidir alejarnos de Él eternamente. You know, and that liberty that God has granted us, we're going to decide if we either come to God and surrender to him or basically be lost for the eternity. So, thank you, Brother John. Gracias por este mensaje. Bueno, I just want to mention Sister Valerie. She mentioned that she has some resources. If anybody has any questions about it, you can reach out to Sister Valerie. Si alguien tiene una pregunta que tenga alguna necesidad, ella conoce los recursos. A lo mejor lo puede conectar con la persona apropiada. Ella lo mencionó también aquí en los comentarios. She mentioned it in the comments. Thank you, Sister Valerie. So I just want to throw that out there.
Thank you,
brothers.
Yeah, all I wanted to just share and reiterate is just I really appreciate this word because, again, it just emphasizes that it's all a mindset. It's all on focusing on God and allowing our faith to work. Because it's one thing to have faith, but in order to put our faith into action, there needs to be, you know, again, needs to be the awareness of like what our faith is acting upon and acting in. I mean, we can't be out there helping the orphans and the widows, as the verse says, unless we're presently there. And I think that's just the beautiful thing of God, where there's so many things in our lives personally, I could even attest to that, where it forces us, so to speak, forces us to think long term, to think ahead and look down the line, all that, where God's like, that's cool and all that, but presently there's work to do and all that. And you just have to have that faith that as we presently go along in his workmanship, that the down the line stuff is being taken care of. And it's just the same thing with God's work, just like with Abraham when he was tested with all that. You know, I mean, Pastor Bruno said it's over 20 some odd years. And just in that, it's like, imagine just waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting for that. But even in that, I think he's known as the father of faith, not just because he waited, but because he didn't have, like, I'm trying to think of the phrasing of it, but I don't think he was like the obsessively waiting type. You know, I think he was just doing the things that it's like, all right, God, you promised this, so I'm gonna wait. Go about my life, but I know this promise is coming. It's just, when is it coming? And I think in that, just again, like we've talked about before, just the confidence in our faith, that reassurance our faith brings that God is moving. So that's why I think it ties in perfectly with Brother Olaga's lesson that God gave upon his heart. It was just that our mindset needs to be focused on the things of God, so that way the faith can be put into action with the confidence that we're going to be taken care of as we act.
Amen. I mean, amen. That's great. That's great input, and just really wrapping it all up. And so that's pretty much our discussion for this month on true religion. Esto termina nuestro tema por este mes. Pero en el mes de noviembre tenemos otro tema, otro escrituras. Está ahí en Colosenses, capítulo 2, donde si estamos en estos versículos o en este capítulo, si puedes leer y estudiar en el mes que viene, que nosotros estamos completo en Cristo, en todas las cosas que Él está hecho, all the things that He is doing that makes us complete. So next month we will have a new theme. This is the end of James for now. And but next month we'll be talking about Colossians chapter 2, and the theme will just be complete in Him. And there's the chapter is just full of goodness. Este capítulo está lleno de carne, hermanos, para nuestros almas, para nuestros, you know, camino con Dios. And yo pienso está un gran ayuda para nosotros. There's just so much that's there. And so we'll start talking about that next week and get some really goodness from that. So you might want to go ahead and read it. Read it this week or next week. And so you'll be ready. Es un buen idea para leer este capítulo en Colosenses, capítulo 2, because sabe que se comienza la discusión en la semana que viene. So we're going to go ahead and just close with a word of prayer. Let's also keep Brother Dan Moran. He's also part of the Verones board, district board. Oramos por hermano Daniel Moran. Está enfermo también. Él también es parte de los Verones distrito. So, y en el nombre de Jesús. So why don't we just go ahead and just close with a word of prayer. Oramos. Gran Señor, muchas gracias por esta enseñanza. Su palabra, Señor. Gracias que ayuda en una gran manera para escucharlo en esta manera, en este estudio, en esta plataforma. Ayuda a nosotros, Señor, porque aquí estamos querando para servir, Señor, en esa manera. We're just praising you and just thanking you, God, for your word, for the study that we had, and just this platform that we had, just to learn and to hear and just to be a part of. We just thank you and praise you. We're asking for Dan Moran, God, that you just bring him the healing that he needs in his body. Señor, también por hermano Moran, Ayúdalo, Señor, da la fuerza, él necesita, sánalo en tu nombre. We just thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless all of you. Thank you so much for joining us. Gracias, hermanos, que están con nosotros. Tienes un buen semana en el nombre de Jesús. Have a wonderful week.
God bless you.
Dios bendiga, hermanos. No se los olvide compartir. Don't forget to share, brothers. God bless you. Good night. Buenas noches.
Good night. God bless you.